हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज द सेकेंड लेक्चर इन एसी टू एसी कन्वर्टर्स एंड इन दिस लेक्चर आई डिस्कस अबाउट द फेज कंट्रोल ऑफ एसी वोल्टेज रेगुलेटर्स। सो इन द लास्ट क्लास आई डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द इंटीग्रल ड्यूटी साइकिल कंट्रोल ऑफ एसी वोल्टेज रेगुलेटर्स। सो दिस इज अगेन द सिंगल फेज एसी वोल्टेज रेगुलेटर एज यू कैन सी इन फिगर वन। ओके, सो फॉर constructing this circuit we require two anti-parallel thyristors. Okay, so in positive half thyristor T1 will conduct, in negative half of the input voltage this thyristor T2 will conduct. Okay, so this is again we are having this resistive load, so input side will be connected to the output side whenever these thyristors are conducting. Okay, so you can see we are having sinusoidal input waveform which is having peak value of Vm, and RMS value of the input we can find by Vm upon root 2. Okay, so for example, if we are triggering this thyristor at time omega t is equal to alpha. Okay, so at this time we have triggered T1, so input side will be connected to the output side. So input side at that instant of time, you can see here, it will start from this. Okay, so at the output we are getting this waveform. Okay, if you are having purely resistive load, we can also find what will be the output current. So this will be simply output voltage divided by the resistance. So output voltage, we are having this wave shape. If R value is more than 1, then we will have current waveform something like this. Okay, so similar waveform, but it will be scaled down. Similarly, for negative half cycle, this thyristor will not turn on. So thyristor T2 will be turned on at that point of time. So you can see that negative cycle of the input voltage will pass to the load, and output voltage you will get waveform something like this. Okay, here one important thing is the thyristor T1 will be naturally commutated whenever current through thyristor becomes zero. So thyristor will be turned off. Okay, so you can see here that thyristor is turned off at omega t is equal to pi. Okay, so you can find what will be the time at which the thyristor T1 will be turned off. Okay, so gate pulses, actually we are supplying a high amp magnitude pulse for a very short duration of time at this instant of time. So this is the gate pulse of T1. So for gate pulse of T2, we have to apply it at pi plus alpha. So at interval pi plus alpha, we have applied the gate pulse to thyristor T2. Okay, so this is the basic principle. So by controlling the alpha value, we can actually control the RMS value of the output voltage. Okay, so we can shift this. Okay, we can reduce alpha, we can increase alpha, so that we can have variable AC voltage at the output. So RMS value of the output voltage we can find. Okay, so this is actually square root 2. So output voltage we can find, you can see here. So if we square this waveform, so this part will come upside and the time period will become 0 to pi. Okay, so if we integrate in 0 to pi, we'll get the RMS value of the output voltage. So you can see here, if we integrate 0 to pi, so 0 to alpha, the output voltage is 0, then alpha to pi. So input voltage we can write root 2 Vs sin omega t, we can square that value, where Vs is the RMS value of the input voltage, and we have to integrate in one interval, that is pi. So 1 upon pi alpha to pi square of the signal, then we have to take the square root. So we will get the RMS root mean square value of the output voltage. Okay, which is Vs 1 upon pi minus alpha plus sin 2 alpha upon 2 square root. Okay, this is very very important relationship between input and output voltage, which is a function of alpha. So by changing alpha, actually we can change this output RMS value. Okay, so by varying alpha from 0 to pi, output can be varied from Vs to 0. Okay, the gating circuit of thyristor T1 and T2 must be isolated, because you can see here that this anode, and here we are having cathode. Okay, so for that we require two isolation circuits for this thyristor. In order to reduce the number of isolation circuits, we can use two power diodes. So you can see here that this combination, with this combination we are having common cathode, so one isolation circuit will be enough to construct this circuit, but additional devices will incur additional power losses. Okay, now there is a problem. So there is a single phase full wave AC voltage controller which is having a load of 10 ohm and input voltage is 120 volt RMS at 60 hertz. The delay angle of the thyristors are given to be pi by 2. So we have to determine the RMS output voltage, the input power factor, the average current of thyristor and RMS current of thyristor. Okay, so this is straightforward problem. The RMS output voltage you can find from this expression. So you can see VO is equal to Vs 1 upon pi, pi minus alpha plus sine 2 alpha upon 2. So substitute alpha is equal to pi by 2. So this will become pi minus pi by 2, that is pi by 2, and sine pi is 0. So this term will become 0. This is pi by 2. So pi get cancelled. So 1 upon 2 and square root. So Vs upon square root 2. So Vs, that is RMS input voltage, is given, that is 120 volt. If we divide by root 2, we are getting the output RMS value. Okay. Similarly, in part B, the input power factor you have to calculate. Okay. So first we have to find what is the VA. So you can see that output RMS current will be output RMS voltage divided by resistance. So this will be 84.85 divided by 10. So this will be the RMS output current. So power delivered to the load, I naught square into R. So this is 719.95 watt, because the input current is the same as the output load current. So the input VA rating will be Vs into Is is equal to Vs I naught. Okay, 120 into output RMS current is 8.485. So you substitute here, so input VA is this much. Okay, so input power factor is nothing but output power upon input VA. So again, you can write here V naught into I naught. This you can write Vs into I naught. I naught get cancelled, because input and output RMS currents are same. So VO upon Vs. So this is VO upon Vs is nothing but 1 upon pi, pi minus alpha plus sine 2 alpha upon 2 square root. So if you do that, you are getting power factor to be 0.707, which is lagging. Okay. Now average thyristor current. So you can see here, in this actually, this is the thyristor current from T1, then it is 0. Okay, then next cycle will start at 2 pi plus alpha. So you have to integrate in 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so I'm integrating it 1 upon 2 pi alpha to pi, then pi plus pi to 2 pi, actually it is 0. So we have to substitute that value. Do the simple integration, you will get the RMS average thyristor current, which is 2.7 amperes. Okay, similarly you can find what will be the RMS value of the thyristor current. You have to square it. Okay, then you have to mean it. So in this actually you have to take square root and you have to square this function. Okay, you will get the RMS value of the thyristor current. Okay, now again we are having this single phase AC voltage regulator, but we are having now RL load, as you can see here. Okay, so in RL load actually current will lag from the output voltage. That's why inductor will store some energy. So whenever voltage becomes zero, current will not become zero. Okay, it will become zero after some time. So you can see here that when T1 is triggered,